Amigo, mga ate, kuya, welcome back to my YouTube channel again, Australiana Bisaya. Today's video guys, magluto kami ng roast pork. At saka, alam nyo ba, hindi namin nabili yung pork, libre lang kasi walang barcode or walang label. So, tara! Samahan nyo kaming magluto. A simple way of cooking roast pork. We got this from the chef for free kasi there's no barcode, isn't it, darling? You can't believe it. Okay? So first thing, need to put an oil. Is it right? Olive oil or not? Doesn't matter. Both sides, and then you need to massage it. Why you need to massage it, darling? And put some salt. And then massage. Para magandang pagkaluto. And then put the magic sauce to make it taste it very yummy and delicious. Lagyan nyo ng magic. Some seasonings. Another seasonings. Both sides. Put it in the cook matinga roast pork. So you put it in 200 degree and then nakasit yan for 1 hour. So guys, so yan na. So we need to check it. You have a look or need to sit another? You need to sit another an hour? Need to sit another an hour. Because it's not cooked yet, so guys, lutong-luto na siya! Yes! I'm very hungry, and then I'm gonna cook dried fish. Guys, lutong-luto na siya, so crispy, yum. Let's eat. Guys, roast pork, luto na. And dried fish and chili and Foxy. Yum yum. Our dinner guys, kain tayo. So yan na. At saka yung porky natin at saka yung chili. Nam nam. Look at that guys, so crispy. Yano natin yung Nanta. The chili and the crispy crackling. Yum. Ang sarap pagkaluto guys, ang sarap pagkaluto. Nandiyan pa yung meat, oh. Hindi pa natapos. Hindi pa nakuha. Mm-hmm.
As a hotel quarantine bridge.
That was a result has come from a male hotel quarantine security guard in his 20s.
Premier Martin Cameron ordered a staff 5-day lockdown from 6 p.m. per time for its 3 most populated regions.
No.
Peel and the southwest, closing schools and businesses. Everyone but essential workers ordered to stay home.
It's pretty tough. It's as hard as anywhere designed to try and crush the virus and stop the
millions of
in Western Australia.
The positive case is a security guard employed in hotel quarantine at the Sheraton Hotel in Perth. He was working on the same floor as a returned traveller of the UK variant of the virus. So far, his close contacts have tested negative, but
we can expect that they will become positive in coming days.
The health authorities say he also worked driving an Uber. That took him to supermarkets, fast food outlets, hair salons, unwittingly exposing members of the general public over the last few days.
This is a very serious situation. We have a problem. We need to stay. The people of the state.
Who the fuck this?
Has now recommended other states stop any travel into Western Australia. From the PM, the coming days will be difficult for many Western Australians, but we're confident WA will be able to get on top of the current outbreak. A shock on the day South Australia and Tasmania opened to Greater Sydney. The Dong family reuniting after the children were stuck with their grandma when the SA border closed.
Mama, 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 mama,
mama,
yung lib ito na yung libre na roast pork namin guys, libre namin, libre namin sa supermarket today. Hindi kami makapaniwala na may libre pa, first time in our life talaga. Nga unta
before this latest case, the entire nation had reached 14 days without community transmission. Now,
we're back
to the waiting game. Ursula Hager, 15 minutes. 5 now to Jake and Tigger.
I'm not sure.
We've got breaking news from Queensland Health Authorities about the situation in Perth.
Maybe there's lots of breaking news tonight here in Queensland. Queensland has declared Perth a COVID-19 hotspot. From tonight, anyone coming into the Sunshine State, from metropolitan Perth, Peel, or the southwest of WA is required to go into mandatory hotel quarantine. Devices welcome Queensland houses. Anyone in Queensland right now, between the 9th February since January 26th, must get tested and isolate until you get your results back. Despite new developments tonight, Chris, there are no changes to plans to bring down the high border closure here. Of course, from 1 o'clock tomorrow morning, Sydney side should be welcomed back into Queensland. Police tell me it's a 2-day job to get things all wrapped up. Tonight, we're going to start with the Martins before turning their attention tomorrow morning to the police checkpoints. And then tomorrow night, they will be taking away the concrete.
Now, warns at least 2,000 administration sites nationwide. Double what it initially proposed.
Let me kayo,
let me
kayo. All diseases eventually, have got that scale practice.
Goal to have the entire population vaccinated by the end of October.
They said we're at the final appeal, if you want. They said they had a certain amount done by March,
now
they're working out.
Thank you.
The European Union continues to reassure our diplomats it won't block Australia's initial international.
You're in the video.
It's
very yummy.
Alexa, you want to stop keeping
TV host Andrew O'Keefe has been charged with domestic assault. The 49-year-old was arrested in the early hours of this morning when police were called to a unit in Randwick investigating reports a woman had been attacked. O'Keefe is a former chairman of the White Ribbon charity, which campaigns to stop violence against women. He's been charged with common assault. He'll face court later this week. The CEO of Facebook has pleaded with the federal government to back down on proposed changes to media. Josh Frumberg spoke with Mark Zuckerberg last week and said the tech boss failed to convince him. Google was threatened to pull its search engine from his...
Ang sarap! Finger licking good! Yum!
The Prime Minister has spoken...
So yan guys, yun lang ang pagtira sa... mukbang kong mag-isa.